a thing that I wanted to share with you, Yao. So did I tell you that the idea is that you download these files regarding your lessons and the rest as well if you want, so you can have your own library. So for example, today is continuous, I think it's the topic, today's topic. So you add, so you download the file, you've got 30 days to download the file. The idea is that you create a folder on your PC, you add a title to it, so continues, and then the idea is that if you don't want to keep paying me, let's say that 1 year, like Dustin, so he doesn't want to pay me anymore, so that he's got his own library on his computer where he knows that he will find the lessons that he already likes, like the topics that he wanted to learn, he already learned them some way. Maybe if he's forgetting, he just needs to go back to this folder and review it, maybe do some exercises, and maybe take a lesson once a month or once a week, and to kind of help him with some questions. That would be it. So the idea is that I want you to be self-reliant regarding learning Spanish.
Yeah, sure. Got it.
So let's continue then. Tell me if the screen size is okay, please. That's actually the wallpaper. That's actually the reason why I'm like, well, invest in yourself. The best investment in your life. So so what's the screen size like? Is it good?
It's not clear. Okay, yeah. No, it's good.
Yeah, okay. So let's continue then. So we got till some friends, you're working. Okay, yeah, yes, I have a lot to do. How would you say that in Spanish? Yes, I have a lot to do.
Sí, tengo mucho a hacer.
I would say demasiado. And the idea is that you might want to add like a stressful kind of tone to it, to that translation. Like, sí, tengo demasiado por hacer.
Tengo demasiado por hacer.
Tengo demasiado por hacer.
Tengo demasiado por hacer.
Yeah, good. Dustin, well, Diao, ¿cómo lidias con el estrés?
¿Cómo la idea qué?
¿Cómo lidias con el estrés?
Lo siento, no lo entiendo.
Okay, ¿cómo manejas el estrés?
Estrés. No sé. Tomo un baño.
¿Qué?
Tomo un baño y me acostar temprano.
Okay. ¿Y qué pasa cuando no te puedes acostar? Cuando tienes mucho por hacer, estás estresada. ¿Cómo haces para lidiar con ese estrés?
Escucho música muy latino.
Muy latina.
Rápido
un ritmo rápido.
Muy rápido, sí.
Okay, so like ritmos rápidos te relajan.
Sí.
That's weird. you reminded me of a friend that I used to go to, a female friend, and it was reggaeton. I mean, you know what reggaeton is, right?
Yeah, sí.
So I used to go to her place, and she had her stereo so freaking loud. Like, it was like the walls were trembling, like that loud. And I went into her bedroom, and I was like, what are you doing? And she was studying and reading. And I was like, why have you got music like on? And she was like, oh, that helps me concentrate. I was like, shit, that's weird. Okay.
Yeah. Me gusta mucho el reggaeton.
Sí. Y si sabes bailar reggaeton. Ya, ¿sabes bailar reggaeton?
¿Qué?
¿Sabes bailar reggaeton?
Ah, sí, sí. Sé un poco de bailar. Me gusta bailar. Bailar de manera china, manera latina.
Okay, I think that the one thing in common, like that, I would say 98% of women have in common is dancing. That all women like dancing. Like, I haven't met the first woman who doesn't like dancing. Like, they're all like, oh yeah, I love dancing. Even if you're not a party animal, you still like that, like many women, like all, like most of the ones that I know, at least. So.
Oh, I think it's not common for Chinese girls, like no? dancing. No, it's like they are very shy, introverted. So, yeah, I think okay. I'm not typical.
Okay, I mean, yeah, you're traveling. That's, you need a lot of guts to travel and be doing what you have been doing this last year.
Yeah.
So, okay, let's have a look at the company I work for isn't doing so well this year, Dustin.
La compañía a que trabajo,
So I want you to pay attention to the translation of this because it's quite tricky in Spanish. And that's the reason why it took me a while to learn it in English, because it's kind of upside down. So okay. In Spanish we kind of say the company for which I work isn't doing so well this year.
Okay. La compañía para
la yo, cual
al cual yo trabajo no hice bien este año.
So, let's do it again, Dustin. Repeat after me. La compañía. Para la cual.
Trabajo.
No le está.
Yendo.
También. So that también is tan, T-A-N, space, tan, sí. Bien, right? Not también as in two or as well.
Sí, sí.
This year.
Este año.
Okay. Yao, ¿qué te impulsó a trabajar en Panamá? ¿Qué te motivó? ¿Qué te motivó a trabajar en Panamá, a ir a Panamá?
No lo entiendo. ¿Qué temo esta frase?
¿Qué te motivó? ¿Motivó?
¿Qué te motivó?
So you see that kind of dot over the O?
Yeah, the tilde.
Yeah, the tilde, yeah. So that means that's where you should pronounce the accent, like the stronger syllable is that one. Sí. So, ¿qué te motivó a ir a Panamá?
Me gusta mucho la agricultura familiar actualmente, y ahora en Latinoamérica hay mucho de esas maneras de cultivar la tierra. Eso es la razón que la motiva, que me motivó.
Exactly. Esa fue la razón que me motivó.
Uh-huh. Esa que fue la razón.
Motivó.
¿Cuándo volvives a China?
Creo que hasta el fin de agosto o septiembre, no sé.
¿Cuándo volverás?
Volverás a China.
Yeah, when will you come back to China? Okay.
Volveré a China en agosto o septiembre.
Nice, volveré. Yeah, good. It's amazing all the Spanish you've learned in these months. It's amazing. It's great. I love doing these lessons because it's really good, and especially people from China. Like I told Anzi that she was my first Chinese. You're my second Chinese student.
Yeah. I love learning Spanish.
Yeah, you do?
Yeah, I love like the culture here and also the way they cultivate their land and everything. Like the personality is very different in Latin America, and I want to be here to experience, and I want to learn the language so that I can fill in soaked by the environment.
Right. Yeah, kind of make it part of your lifestyle, if you will, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that's like I talked about that with Sebastian yesterday in the lesson that I was speaking about a while ago. I was telling him that. He was like, dude, how do you maintain your language knowledge? How do you do it? I mean, because you're not immersed in it. And I was like, well, the first thing is that you must be motivated. You must fall in love with the language. Like, yeah. There is no, I must, there, like I said that must, but I meant like, you should push yourself, but in that very positive way that it's like what you said, that you love doing it, just like riding a bicycle, just like, I don't know, watching TV. And he was actually telling me like, hey, but I don't understand a lot of stuff when I watch TV in English. And I was like, it takes time, but once you get the hang of understanding people talking in English, the same as in Spanish,
yeah,
then it becomes really passive. Like, you don't need to put so much effort once it becomes a passive learning. What I mean by that is that you already reading in Spanish and you don't think so much about the words that you don't know, or you listen to people and you understand them and you don't feel that kind of stress or headache. Have you had that headache in your head that you're like, oh, I don't want any more Spanish whatsoever? I guess that you have had that. Probably, no?
Yeah, I have like some bottleneck when I learn Spanish. The period you feel you learn every day, you learn very hard, and there's no progress. But after I get through it.
Exactly, yeah, exactly. It's like a freaking wall, like a virtual wall on your mind, something like that. And you're like, you're trying to break it. You're right. And you're just like, shit, I'm not making progress. That's what the average person thinks. But if you learned one pronunciation, if you learned a word, if you learned just a very little thing about the language, or not even about the language, but the culture itself, yeah, you're still making progress. Now, I think humans, we tend to like instant gratification.
Yes, absolutely.
And we start languishing, oh, in 3 months I'll get this. Yeah, right. Go ahead and try.
That's what I'm thinking. That's what I'm thinking, like, starting, I don't understand. I'm going to learn it half a year, but it's not possible.
I mean, there are people, I've met people who have made the progress that you have made from Spanish to English in 6 months, but I've only met those like probably two or three people in my whole life. So those are definitely the exception genius to the rules.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that's the thing. Dustin, you're so quiet.
Oh, no. Estoy escuchando.
Okay, you're learning. Sí. Okay, so let's do the next example. So is your English getting better? How would you say this?
Oh, yo?
Yeah, Dustin,
oh, okay.
Go ahead.
Es su inglés... ¿Es su inglés? ¿Más bueno ahora?
So repeat after me. ¿Está?
¿Está?
¿Tu inglés?
¿Tu inglés?
¿Mejorando?
¿Mejorando?
Yeah, nice. Yeah, the next one. Sí. The population of the world is increasing very fast.
La población del mundo está aumentando muy rápido.
Está aumentando o está creciendo o está incrementando muy rápido. Okay?
Okay.
So, incrementando.
Incrementando.
Yeah, good. So, the next one, Yao, pregunta. ¿Qué piensas de tener hijos?
Tener hijos es un proyecto de toda la vida. Es una decisión muy, muy en serio.
Es una decisión muy, muy importante o muy, Pero sí. Piensas, ¿quieres tener hijos? ¿Te gustaría tener hijos?
Sí, voy a tener hijo o hija dos, creo que.
Okay, with a Latin American guy.
Yeah, probably. Probably.
That would be interesting. Okay, so the next one. At first, Dustin, at first I didn't like my job, but I'm beginning to enjoy it now.
En la primera, no me gusta mi trabajar, pero estoy empezando a disfrutar ahora.
Okay, so let's do it again. Repeat after me. Al comienzo.
A comienzo.
No me gustaba.
No me gustaba.
Mi trabajo.
Mi trabajo.
Pero.
Pero.
Estoy empezando.
Estoy empezando.
A disfrutarlo.
A disfrutarlo.
Ahora.
Ahora.
Good.
¿Y cómo es la palabra para at first?
At first, al comienzo.
Al comienzo.
It's just that in Spanish we don't say at first, we say at the beginning. It's more like at the beginning. Because al comienzo, like at first, that would be like al primero, but we wouldn't say that. It wouldn't make any sense.
Also, Casey.
Al comienzo, blah, blah, blah. Okay, so let's have a look at the exercises. So you need to match the left side with the right side. So the first one is please don't make so much noise. I'm trying to work. We already did that. Yeah, let's do the second one. I need to eat something soon. So that would be I'm getting hungry. So how do you say that in Spanish?
Tengo mucho hambre.
Sí. Pero la primera parte, I need to eat something soon. How do you say that?
Necesito comer algo, cosas.
Necesito pronto. Comer algo pronto.
Necesito comer algo pronto. Sí.
Perfect. Yaoka, ¿cuántas veces comes al día?
Dos o tres veces yo como cada día.
¿Te gustaría ser vegetariano?
No me gusta.
You like cultivating, but you wouldn't be a veggie fan.
Es muy duro y muy difícil para mí, porque las comidas chinas es muy delicioso y tienen mucho carne.
Tienen mucha
cerdo.
Carne.
Cerdo.
yeah, pork meat is quite tasty.
Yeah.
like every time the girl I'm going out with, every time she's picking food, she's like, what do you want? And I'm like, whatever it's got more meat than anything else, pick that for me. I'm like, whatever it is, if it's got more meat, that's okay for me.
Yeah, so, you're a meat lover.
Yeah, definitely. Like, I know that we're not supposed to eat meat, but I can't help it.
So,
Dustin, I don't have anywhere to live right now. So, that would be, I'm looking for an apartment.
No tengo alguien a vivir ahora. Así que estoy buscando por un apartamento.
Okay, so repeat after me. Dustin, no tengo donde vivir.
No tengo donde vivir.
Ahora mismo.
Ahora mismo.
Estoy buscando un apartamento.
Estoy buscando por un apartamento.
So we don't say for in Spanish. Oh, we just say
estoy
looking.
Estoy buscando un apartamento.
Yep. So, good. Dustin, ¿cuál ha sido el lugar donde más años has vivido?
Y dame la pregunta una vez más.
Sí. ¿Cuál ha sido el lugar en el cual has vivido más años?
5 años.
This one?
Sí.
Okay.
No, 4 años, lo siento. No recuerdo. Okay.
Deje así. Yeah, we need to leave soon. It's starting to rain. Oh no, it's getting late, I think.
Tenemos que salir pronto. Está empezando a llover.
Okay, so repeat after me, ¿no? So necesitamos irnos pronto.
Necesitamos irnos pronto.
Remember that leave is reflexive.
Irme.
Ah, ya.
Irnos. So the other thing that is reflexive is when you say get an adjective. So when you say that, like get and a description, then that means that the verb is going to be reflexive as well. So it's getting late would be se está. Repeat after me. Se está.
Se está
poniendo.
Poniendo.
Tarde.
Tarde.
Yeah, you could say that the translation of that is like, it is putting itself late. That's sort of what we say in Spanish.
Can you repeat it again?
Yeah, kind of like if you said in English, it is putting itself late.
About the Spanish one?
Se está poniendo. It's getting late. I'm just trying to kind of give a translation in English so you can have a better idea of what the translation is.
Se está poniendo, like, sí.
Yeah, se está poniendo, like it is putting itself. Se would be the self part. Tarde, late. So.
Lo siento, pero irme ahora porque tengo trabajar en 30 minutos. Mucho gusto.
Mucho gusto.
Espero que tengamos clases juntos en el futuro. Y Ander, I'll write you on WhatsApp or Skype and we'll schedule this week, okay?
Yeah, please do so. Yeah, that'd be great. So I can arrange probably one lesson with Yao and another one with Sebastian, who you both will know this week,
claro.
Hopefully.
Mucho.
Yeah, we should all three have one. That'd be fun. All right.
Okay, mate, have a nice one. Cheers.
Yeah, you too. See you guys.
Okay. Yeah, well, let's continue. So we need to leave soon. Okay. They don't need their car anymore. How do you say that in Spanish?
Ellos no necesitan.
Yep.
Ellos no necesitan su carros.
Su carro.
Anymore.
Más. Ellos no necesitan su carro más. Okay.
The internet sounds seems a bit.
It's cutting off.
Can you hear me now?
Okay. Yeah, I can hear you now. So I was saying that they don't need their car anymore. Would be ellos no necesitan su carro más.
Más. Ellos no necesitan su carro más.
Nice. So what would the right side be?
They're trying to sell it.
Oh, they're trying to sell it. Yes, they're trying to sell it. So how do you say that?
Ellos están intentando a venderlo.
Without a, only están intentando venderlo.
Venderlo, ellos están intentando venderlo.
Yeah. Pregunta. Pregunta es, ¿cuántas horas duermes al día?
Si puedes hablar más lento.
Okay. ¿Cuántas horas duermes al día?
Yo me dueño.
Yo duermo
7 horas por día.
Al día. Por día is okay, but it sounds more natural to say al día, at least here in Colombia. Okay?
Ah, sí.
So the next one is, things are not, oh no, they don't need, ¿cuántos años tenías? So pay attention to this question, random question. So, ¿cuántos años tenías cuando aprendiste a manejar?
Yo tenía 2 años para aprender manejarlo.
12 años, 12.
Dos años.
No, but I mean like driving a car. Like, ¿cuántos años tenías cuando aprendiste a manejar un carro?
Sí, tenía 2 años para aprender a manejar un carro.
What? 2 years?
Sí.
A car, like learning how to drive a car. And seriously, you're serious? 2 years?
Sí, en China hay un examen
Huh.
para to test your skill and porque estaba en universidad y no tengo mucho tiempo.
Okay, te demoraste. So check this out. Te demoraste, like you took. Te demoraste 2 años en tomar el examen de conducción.
Sí.
Okay, I thought you were 2 years old. I was like, what?
I thought you were asking how many years I need to learn to drive.
No, it was how old were you when you learned how to drive? Okay.
Can you repeat the question again?
Yeah, so that was, ¿cuántos años tenías cuando aprendiste a manejar carro?
¿Cuándo aprendiste a manejar?
Yeah. So the six things I'm not so good at work. Oh no, we did that. No. Things are not good, so good at work, the company is losing money. How do you say that?
Cosas son no cosas son cosas son no bueno son tan bueno a trabajo.
So, let's do repeat after me. So, las cosas
Las cosas
no están
no están,
tan bien
no están tan bien
en el trabajo.
en el trabajo.
The company is losing money. How do you say this in Spanish?
La compañía está perdiendo su dinero.
Está perdiendo dinero.
Estoy aprendiendo dinero.
Perdiendo, perdiendo.
Perdiendo dinero.
Yeah, aprendiendo is learning.
Yeah.
And the very last
Perdiendo.
one of the day, and we'll be done for today. So we're going to get wet. It's starting to rain.
Vamos a hacer wet.
Vamos a mojarnos.
Vamos a mojarnos.
Yeah, so it's starting to rain.
Está lloviendo, está empezando a llover.
Perfect. So tell me, have you got any questions about what we had a look at today about the approach? How do you feel?